We will also consider one more example. We'll consider one more example. In these examples, in these two examples, we have taken negative side. We have taken negative side as reference. We have taken positive side as reference, and we have calculated the voltage at different points of the circuit. Now, let us move to another example in which we will not take the reference level as positive or negative side of the battery, just we will take the any midpoint of the circuit as the reference level. Now let us draw the circuit. So again, we are going to have a battery of 12 volt, a battery of 12 volt, right? A battery of 12 volt. And then this is the point D. And then we are having a resistor R. And then we are having the point C. And then again we are having a resistor of resistance R. And then we are having a point B. And then again we are having a resistor R. And then we are having a point A, and this point A then will be connected to the positive side of the battery, right? Now you know how the current will be flowing. Current flows from higher voltage to lower voltage, and what is the higher voltage? This will be the positive side of the battery, okay? Though you must know that the electrons always flows from negative side to positive side, but by convention we take the direction of the current opposite to the electron flow, right? So we are having direction of current flow from positive side to negative side, okay? Now let us consider the reference level. The reference level, suppose we take you can see the resistor which is connected between B and C point. So let us take the midpoint of this resistor as the reference level, right? Now at this reference level, the voltage should be 0 volt. Now you know, if you go upper side, it should be positive. Why positive? Why positive? Because this side is connected to the positive side, okay? And this should be on the higher side, right? Then only we have to, we will be able to follow the rules, right? Now, the lower part should have negative voltage because this side is connected to the negative side of the battery, right? Now, as you know, what will be the voltage at point C? This is point C. What will be the voltage? This voltage is going to be minus 2 volt, okay? This is going to be minus 2 volt at point C. Now, what will be the voltage at point D? It will be further negative. Why? It will be further negative because this is connected to the negative side, more negative, right? Higher side, the highest side negative. So this is going to be minus 6 volt. Similarly, at point B, what will be the voltage? This is the point B is on the upper side of the reference level, which is the midpoint of this resistor. So this is going to be plus 2 volt. Now again, what will be the voltage at point A? This will be further positive, right? Why? Because A point is connected to the positive side of the battery, and this is going to be plus 6 volt, right? Do you get that? Okay, so I think these three examples, they might have been helpful for you to understand that how can we calculate the voltage at different points with respect to the reference in the circuit, right? Okay.